हेलो एंड वेलकम यू वंस अगेन इन दिस न्यू सेशन ऑफ हिस्ट्री एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम टॉपिक ऑफ द जैनिज्म टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द मेन टीचिंग ऑफ द जैनिज्म्स जैनिज्म ऑफ द महावीरा हैज द फिफ्थ वाव द फाइव वाव वाज अहिंसा नॉन वायलेंस आचार्य और असत्य नॉट स्टीलिंग थर्ड इज सत्य नॉट टेलिंग अ लाय देन अपारगृह नॉट पोजेसिंग प्रॉपर्टी एंड ब्रह्मचार्य प्रैक्टिसिंग चेस्टिटी देन नाइन ट्रूथ्स देर वॉज अ नाइन ट्रूथ बाय महावीर जैन एंड दीज नाइन ट्रूथ्स वर जीवा लिविंग थिंग्स अजीवा नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स पुण्य Results of the good deeds, paap, sin, ashrav, good deed, sanvar, hindrance in the way of karma, bandha means bondage, nirjara means destructions of karmas and moksha. These were the nine truth. Doctrines of Jainism was Tri Ratna. And the three ratna means three jewels. These were right faith, right knowledge, and right conduct. Then karma. The Jain believe in the karma theory of Hinduism. And that one should be responsible for one's own karma and action. Then it was an equality. Equality. Where Mahavira laid stress to the equality between the men and women as well as between the men and the men. He preached universal brotherhood. He considered all men equal irrespective of their caste and creed. Then, eternal soul. Mahavira believed in the immortality of the soul that is Atma. He said, the body dies but not a soul and salvation. Like Hindu, Jains also believe in moksha, that is salvation or freedom from the cycle of birth and rebirth. That is why he gave the three ratna, that is right faith, right knowledge and right action. And believe in penance, where Jain believed in the penance to die of starvation called santha ya salekha. Was considered a virtue. Now spread of Jainism. Jainism had a royal patronage. Therefore, it spread easily around Kosala, Magad, Mithila, Champa, and other parts of country. Causes of the spread of Jainism was local dialect. Second one was the royal patronage. Jainism received the royal patronage by Chandragupta Maurya is said to have been converted Jainism in the later years. In the 5th century, Chalukyas and Rashtrakutas also patronized Jainism. Kharvela, the ruler of Kalinga, helped in the spread of Jainism in eastern India. Saints. There were many devout Jain saints like Kalkacharya, who lived in Ujjain and made its center of Jainism. Another Jain saint, Bhadrabahu, took Jainism to Karnataka. Division of the two sects were Shvetambar, the white clads. There were the two sects are there. One is Shvetambar and another race, Digambar. Digambar followed the Bhadrabahu and it was Shvetambar or the white clads were led by Sthulabhadra. So, impact of the Jainism, it was in political impact in earlier ages, stages, it is success were more remarkable than the Buddhism. However, it was mainly the Kshatriyas who took to his new faith. As a result, they lost their warlike instincts. It is one of the reasons why Jain did not try to build any political empire of their own. Social and religious impact. Jainism discarded the system of casteism, shunned rituals, and encouraged social services. The language and literature. The Jain scholars have made an important contribution in the literary field. The Jain texts were written in Prakrit, but at some places these texts were also written in a local languages, and they are finally compiled in the 6th century AD at Vallabhi in Gujarat. Art and architecture. Jain constructed a temple and monasteries. Relics are found in Khandagiri and Udaygiri caves in Odisha. Jain constructed hundreds of dharmashalas, opened several orphanages, and support many charitable institutions. Now we will start with the Buddhism. Buddhism was created to a religious striving to the time. It was midway between the Hinduism and the Jainism. Buddhism presented the ascetic traditions to Indian society. It had more followers abroad than in India. Buddhism is one of the imprints that India has left on other civilization. Gautam Buddha. Who was Gautam Buddha? Gautam Buddha was the founder of the Buddhism. He belonged to the Kshatriya clan of Sakya. According to one legend, he was born in 563 BCE at Lumbini and Kapilavastu in Nepal. His childhood name was Siddharth. His father was Suddhodana, was the ruler of Kapilavastu. Like Mahavira, he was inclined from his childhood toward the spiritual pursuits. The great renunciation. Once Gautam charioteer was driving him through the town. The appearance of an old man bent with age moved Gautam. Again the sight of a Sikh. It was the first he saw that old man bent with his age. Then again his sight a Sikh man growing with the pain, with pathetic. The dead body was of a man being carried to the cremation made Gautam think about the man's destiny. He was consoled when he saw an ascetic in search of salvation. These sites are known as the four great sites. Gautam left home, his wife and the child, in order to find the solution. This event is known as Mahabhishkarma or Great Renunciation. Enlightenment. After leaving home for a search of truth, Gautam wandered from one place to another place. For some time he studied under the renowned teachers of Rajagriha and then went to Gaya. He practiced severe penance and led a life of extreme austerity. Finally, at the age of 35, he attained the enlightenment at Bodh Gaya in Bihar. From then onward, he began to be called a Buddha or an enlightenment one. Dharma Chakra Pravartan. At the place where Buddha got enlightenment, a temple known as Mahabodhi Temple was constructed later. The peepal tree is now referred as the Mahabodhi tree. Buddha was called the Tathagat, the founder of truth after enlightenment. He delivered his first sermon in Deer Park in Sarnath near Varanasi in the presence of the five ascetics. This event in the history of Buddhism is known as Dharma Chakra Pravartan or turning of the wheel of sacred law. Gautam Buddha in his last year went to Kushinagar, which is near Gorakhpur district in Uttar Pradesh. He obtained Maha परिनिर्वाण एट द एज ऑफ 80 इन 483 BC एट कुशीनगर. हिज डिसिपल्स टुक हिज सेक्रेट रिमेन्स टू 8 डिफरेंट प्लेसेस वेयर ह्यूज माउंट्स कॉल्ड स्तूपास वर इरेक्टेड. So what was the teaching of Buddhism? Buddha followed the simple path and inspired with the four noble truths. And the four noble truths were, world is full of suffering, the suffering has a cause, desire is cause of suffering, and if desire is stopped, suffering can be stopped. Then eightfold path were the way of the nirvana in Buddhism. On the path that leads to removal of suffering is known as the eightfold path. And these eightfold path were right action, that means to remain away from the theft, luxuries and the violence. Right thought means to remain away from the empty rituals and worldly evils. Third, right belief, to give up desire, right living, not to have dishonest dealing, right speech and right effort. And the seventh one is right recollection, and eighth is right meditations. Attitude towards the God. Attitude towards the God. Buddha held that the whole universe was controlled by dharma. He believed that all the world is controlled by dharma, a universal law. So he was silent about the existence of the God, though he never formally denied it, like Mahavira. His code of conduct, Buddha formulated the code of conduct that was not to tell lie, not to own property, not to consume alcoholic drinks, not to commit violence, and not to indulge its corruption. So that's all for today's session. We will meet in our next session. We will continue the same chapter. Till then, have a nice day and take care of your health.